السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. الحمد لله. الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستهديه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فهو المهتدي ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن سيدنا محمدًا عبده ورسوله صلى الله على سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم. Thank you very much for your efforts to make it to celebrate the life of a wonderful human being called Nabila Shamsuddin. We are not going to grieve or depress ourselves with the facts of life. The Imam had mentioned death, and all of us, we are aware of this existential fact. كل نفس ذائقة الموت. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, إِنَّكَ مَيِّتٌ وَإِنَّهُمْ مَيِّتُونَ. No skeptic can become the skeptic of death. This is the most democratic institution in our life. Nabila made good use of her life. She wasn't after anything worldly. She wasn't after power. She wasn't after money. She wasn't after prestige. Her focus and goal is the pleasure of Almighty God. To make use of her life, her efforts, her days, her money for the service of others, for charity, for good work. In the Quran we read the word وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ, to do good, hundreds of times. Always comes after believe in God. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ. She was very keen on this concept, and she spent her life doing good to others. Nabila was also very keen and very conscious of the issue of sincerity and the acceptance of her deed by Almighty God. She was so much preoccupied that all her deeds to be done in a hidden way. Her left hand does not know what her right hand is doing. She doesn't make any big thing of whatever she is doing, of endeavors to help others. She is so preoccupied with the issue of al-ikhlas and al-qabul. She always, when I used to carpool with her, her school here is on the way of my office, which is probably 5 miles away, south. She always in the car reminds me, if we are going to do good, for any worldly thing, it's better to stay home or do something else. Have fun. But if we are doing this purely because it is good and it is helpful and it brings happiness and smile to the faces and the pleasure of Almighty God, then let us go. And she reminds me of an ayah in Surah Ali Imran, which says, لا تحسبن الذين يفرحون بما أتوا ويحبون أن يحمدوا بما لم يفعلوا لا تحسبنهم بمفازة من العذاب. So this is a warning that if you do things for other than the pure purpose of doing good, آمن وعمل الصالحات, and for the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then you're a loser. Also, she reminds me of an ayah in Surah Al-Mu'minun, which says, وَالَّذِينَ يُؤْتُونَ مَا آتَوْا وَقُلُوبُهُمْ وَجِلَةٌ أَنَّهُمْ إِلَىٰ رَبِّهِمْ رَاجِعُونَ. And here Aisha radiallahu anha, Umm al-Mu'mineen, asked the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam about the meaning of this ayah. Is it those wrongdoers who do bad things? In the Day of Judgment, they will stand up in front of God and He will ask them questions. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told her, no, Yabnat al-Siddiq. This is the people who do good, the people who pray, and the people who give charity, and the people who make fasting and make hajj. And they are trembling in front of God that their deeds will not be accepted. Because it's not pure. It's not ikhlas. It's not for totally the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His pleasure. So Nabila was very keen on this issue. And I kept calm her down. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَاتِ سَيَجْعَلُوا لَهُمُ الرَّحْمَنُ وُدَّا. Those who are good people, who do good, people will love them. So this does not interfere with the sincerity. And also, one of the companions asked the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam that when I do good, people come and hug me and thank me, and is this something interfere with the sincerity? He told them, no. This is tilka ajilu bushra al-mu'min. This is the fruits of doing good. In this life, you will see people love you and cherish you and appreciate you. So inshallah, Nabila, who was so keen on the ikhlas and qabool, Nabila, who was very keen on ikhlas and qabool, showed the fruits of her good deeds with this funeral she had, the burial she had. One of the people said, I never seen such a crowd, except in the Eid, where the plaza is full of people and the cemetery, there's no place to park your car. So we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to accept Nabila and accept her work. And I bear witness that she agonized on the issue of sincerity, ikhlas, and she was very keen on the issue of qabool, to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept works. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with us in His knowledge, in the car and outside the car, and listen to all our conversations about this. So, Alhamdulillah Rabbil Alameen, Nabila lived a life which is well spent, a life which was well lived, a life worthy of the hours and days and years she spent in good deed. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to have her in the place of the righteous, the martyrs, the prophets, وَحَسُنَ أُولَٰئِكَ رَفِيقًا. The poet said, صلى عليك الملائكة الذين تخيروا والصالحون صلى الملائكة الذين تخيروا والصالحون عليك والأبرار وعليك صلوات من ربك كلما نصب الحجيج ملبدين وغاروا لا تكثرن علي إذا لا تكثرن علي إذا جئت تلومني لا يذهبن بحلمك الإكثار كان الخليط هم الخليط فتبدلوا فأصبحوا متبدلين والديار بالديار لا يلبث القرناء أن يتفرقوا ليل يمر عليهم ونهار. May Allah bless you, Nabila, and may Allah give us patience, give me strength to work and do good, because my scare is not that you died and departed. My scare, if I go to hell and you go to heaven, when I am going to see you. So with whatever left of my life, I'm very keen to spend it in doing good, with sincerity, hoping for acceptance and hoping to enter heaven and be with her again. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give patience to my children who I would like to remember their mother and come forward and few words. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give them strength and remind them to be patient. وبشر الصابرين الذين إذا أصابتهم مصيبة قالوا إنا لله وإنا إليه راجعون أولئك عليهم صلوات من ربهم ورحمة وأولئك هم المهتدون. And remind them that she implanted in them the love of the others, the love of humanity, the love, the person next to you, if he's not of your faith, he is your brother in humanity. Be good to him and pray for him. Pray for his heart to open to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I remind you that she spent all her life teaching you moral values, honesty, truth, responsibility, punctuality. We have 100 of those moral values. We taught them to you day and night. And I remind you to follow your conscience, which is fearing of God, the moral compass in this life, which is full of challenges. This is not heaven. This is life. الَّذِي خَلَقَ الْمَوْتَ وَالْحَيَاةَ لِيَبْلُوَكُمْ أَيُّكُمْ أَحْسَنُ عَمَلًا. And I remind my grandchildren who are here. I might not be here too long, but I want you to remember that your parents are the best. We spend a lot of time and money and efforts for the boys and girls to find them the best girls and boys to marry and bring you to this life. I remind you, in the memory of your grandmother, to be obedient to your parents, to listen to them, never say oof to your mom. Remember that all heaven is under her feet. And remember that there is a door called the Father door to heaven. If you want to enter it, remember that to be good to your parents. And also want you to be successful, happy, playing sport and studying hard. The planet Earth full of people, 8 billions, tough competition, challenges, but that's why you are created, to be tested, your metal to be tested. So again, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forgiveness to Nabila and have her in the highest level of the heavens, in Jannatul Firdaus al-A'la. And I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give me wisdom and strength and faith and sincerity to follow her footsteps. Now I would like to ask my sons-in-law or my daughters-in-law or my children who volunteer, all of you, you are going to talk in the memory of your mom, okay? Who carried you like a cat which carries her kittens with her teeth all these years. And I know you love her so dearly. So please, Omar, you are courageous and you have proven yourself, mashallah, to be a good speaker. And he's my competition. Okay, come on in.
Jazakallah khair.